Pradip Bhandari. You know, all this while when they were marching for the last 6 days, there seemed to be no overtures from the Maharashtra government at all. Today was the first time we saw a senior minister reach out, speak to them. But is there a certain impetus? You know, it didn't make the headlines to begin with, and then suddenly as this march just kept getting bigger and bigger, is there a political force now that, you know, cannot really be turned away from? This is something that netas can clearly no longer ignore.
See, at the outset, the farmers are the backbone of this country, and every politician, exactly, irrespective of the party line, understands that. So clearly, I think 2 hours back, the chief minister has also invited them and has been receptive that whatever their demands are would be heard to. And I think their demands are some of their demands come from the crops that they lost because of the hailstorm that they suffered. And let me also remind your viewers that last year, 34,000 crore was the same loan waiver package that the Maharashtra government had given. So this clearly signals that the government is receptive. And I think the principle has been that in Maharashtra since 1971, the average farm holding has reduced from roughly four acres to 1 acre. The landowners have increased 4 times. So, and there are 78% small and medium farmers.
Well.
So, I think the principle has to be addressed from the point of view of irrigation, and that is why the government has already allocated 8,000 crores. Demand right now is somewhat legitimate, and I think the government has shown receptivity.
No, the demand is legitimate. You know, we've seen the Maharashtra government even concede earlier on when the loan waiver was announced, they felt that the demands were legitimate. But between announcing a loan waiver and its implementation, there's been a huge gap. Why does it take 50,000 farmers to march to Mumbai before you know, this even becomes a headline, or this becomes something for a senior minister to reach out?
No, I think it's a valid question, but let me remind you that the deficiency in rainfall has been 16%. So since the loan waiver was announced, in last year the rainfall deficiency was 16%. So that elongated the crisis. That is where you see these farmers somewhat coming forward and expressing that whatever the loan waiver was, because 35 lakh farmers have already received loan waiver.
Maharashtra hasn't implemented the loan waiver fully, neither has Karnataka or Telangana. Does the centre need to step in? Where are we going with our political priorities? I mean, you know, you can talk about 2 lakh crores to support a recapitalised bank, but not even half that amount for farmers.
So I think this time the government has allocated a very historical amount for the agriculture sector. Principally, all of us have debated that the problem with the agriculture sector has been that the farmers are not getting their prices because of the APMC mandis and the middlemen there. So how do you remove that? The agriculture comes in the concurrent list. For the first time, you have the rural hearts being set up. You have the farmer directly selling it to the consumer rather than the middleman deciding the price. So first of all, the problem was that the market price was so low that it was lesser than the production price. That is where the government stepped up. Madhya Pradesh government stepped up with the Bhavantar Yojana, where the difference of the market price and the production price was given to the farmers. Similarly, you had the Telangana government stepping up. So that is one principal problem. The second principal problem is huge in farming is with respect to water. Till the time you do not provide more facilities of drip irrigation, rainwater harvesting, ensuring that per drop you get more output, you will not solve the problem. So it is not something which will be solved in a day. The government is, for the first time, a government has taken a step where the way farming is done, of way farming is looked at it.
Why does it need 50,000 farmers at the end of the day?
I don't think it needs to
be 180-kilometer march for 7 days before we even begin to discuss this.
I think some of it is putting the pressure and also good optics, but there is legitimate demand. The problem cannot be solved by loan waivers, because see, let's understand. If today you provide a loan waiver, tomorrow also the rainfall, there's a deficient rainfall, again the farmer will go to the bank and again the farmer.
I'm going to bring in Krishan B. Chaudhary.